Anyway, Jamie, I'll come to you. Lawrenson's a knob. We've established that. He's been talking about Coutinho, and he's basically said if Coutinho wants to go, you know, all Barcelona links. Over the last couple of days, every single Barcelona player under the sun's been speaking about him. Neymar spoke about him. Xavi spoke about him in the press today. How great he is. There's a big coming at some stage. I'm pretty sure eventually when it is. Lawrenson's basically, I don't want to go too much into it, but he's basically said, if Coutinho wants to go, you can't stop someone from going to the likes of Barcelona or Real Madrid, PSG or even Bayern Munich. The clever thing to do, rather than say Coutinho might be going, what can we do, is to have somebody in place already as a replacement. Why can't Liverpool not sell their best players? Is there something I'm missing? Or what do you think?
I think in the past that we've, you can see with Suarez that, what was it, the 40 million plus £1 thing that Arsenal tried to do. We can keep our best players, and it just shows that when we did keep our best player, we had Suarez and we had that title challenge, and he was, you know, the best player in the team by far for us. I think that we can keep Coutinho, and we definitely can, as long as we go and prove something this season. Either we go and win the league, or at least we get a trophy, or we minimal from this season, we've got to get Champions League football, definitely. And that's key to keeping keeping our best players like Coutinho. So yeah, I think we can do it, but we've just got to prove it.
And Joe, even if Liverpool were fifth, right, or sixth, whatever, in the league, or whatever you want to say, Coutinho's under contract. It emerged last week, Paul Joyce done a story saying there's no buyout or release clause, so he's under contract, he's Liverpool's player. Even if he said he wants to go, like Suarez did, Suarez pushed for the move to Arsenal, he did, and Liverpool just said no. Could we not just do that and just say, no, Phil, you play for Liverpool? There's like a stigma of almost having an unhappy player, and I don't understand it really. He's our employee, and I don't quite get the justification.
I don't get it either, but to be honest, I don't think it's any of it's really that true. I think it's all the papers trying to, we're doing well. They tend to find a story, it comes out every time Liverpool are doing well. It might just be my opinion here, but they try to unsettle the team, say that this player wants to leave, that player wants to leave. I think we should just do like you said with Suarez, and just no bids, don't let him go whatsoever, because we need these players if we're going to push on for the title. Obviously we're top of the league at the moment, that sounds really good, but it feels good, but whether we're there at the end of the season is another thing, but we need to keep on with these players and adding to these players if we want to compete for the title season after season, which Klopp wants to do. So we need to say no to Barcelona and get rid of this mentality of, oh, they're a so-called bigger club, oh, we've got to keel over and just let them have him. No. I think if he goes, it has to be a world record fee.
I'd just tell him to fuck off, Steve, to be perfectly honest.
That's my point, is that there's a thing in football now where it's almost like Real Madrid and Barcelona or Bayern Munich, whatever, can just think, right, I want him, and we're having him, and you can't do fuck all. And it does my head in, because it doesn't work. And I feel sorry for like Southampton fans sometimes, and you know, when we take all their best players, in theory they should just say no, and in theory, you know, unless someone's out of contract or running out, the teams don't think they're that good, or they need the money, then I get it. So for example, if we were skint on the bones of our arse and Barcelona went, there's 18 million for Coutinho, you'd go, makes sense to sell them. But you can't, we've seen in the past, every time Liverpool have put a title challenge together or come second, we've lost a good player, and it sets you back.
Yeah, I was probably of the opinion when we sold Suarez that we could go out and spend that money wisely, and you know, I think I was wrong back then. I think we've seen, and it's been borne out in evidence of how long it's taken. I think we bought really well after Suarez. I think it took 2 years for those signings to show the worth and stuff like that. Phil Coutinho right now, he is playing better than anybody in the league for me right now.
I'm not
saying he's world class yet. But because he's got to prove it, and he, you know, to be world class, you have to do it consistently for at least a year. And we're 3 months into that for me now. You know, last season he was having a good game, maybe 5 good games, a couple of bad games, stuff like that. The thing with Phil Coutinho is he looks like he's enjoying himself at Liverpool. He's definitely enjoying his football. You can see that with Firmino and Mane and the way that they're playing. You can see from the goal celebrations, they're absolutely fucking buzzing. He's taken that now into the Brazil national side as well. That means a lot to him. He's one of those players who's always wanted to play for his country. We've given him that platform. You know, he might be sitting in Brazil's He might be sitting on Barcelona's bench. He might not get into their side yet. Might be 2 years before he's good enough to be into Barcelona's first team, and he wouldn't be getting that Brazilian football. I think right now he's enjoying himself. We don't need the money. Tell them to fuck off. At the end of the day, we might win the league this season. He's bought into this project. Tony Barrett come out and said to squash all of these rumours and quash all of these rumours, we're in pole position. And we are, because he's our fucking player.
That's kind of the point I'm getting at. And he's Lawrence, we know who he is, he's a bit, you know, in the media and stuff, but he is an excellent Liverpool player. He holds Liverpool in high regard, so he was a very good player for us. And yet, even he's thinking, you can't, not you can do. There's nothing you can do. Again, it might be a bit, I might be on my model high horse here, but someone somewhere has got to say to someone, no. And you know what? Dortmund do it quite well, to be fair. Dortmund would, they sometimes would rather let a player's contract run out, just because sometimes I feel like it's out of, well, we'll get the best out of this year and then we'll cope how it happens. He's under contract for so long, I just can't figure for life me why everyone's saying, and you know, other fans message and stuff, you know, oh, he'll be in Barcelona next year. And I get it, because we've shown in the past that Suarez, Alonso, Torres,
Mascherano,
players go, and we've kind of waited at the door and said, Sam, we'll take the money. That's got to stop. If Liverpool want to not be a flash in the, if this doesn't, we don't want this to be a flash in the pan title challenge. We want to be consistently challenging every year. This has to stop.
Yeah, I agree with that. And I think what it boils down to is when we look at FSG and stuff like that, we know that their business model is buy young and sell for a high price and stuff. But I don't think we've fully seen that model realised, because I'm thinking that what they want to do is buy maybe 20, 21, something like that, maybe even younger. Sell 28, 29. Phil Coutinho's got 4 years left, yeah, at least at Liverpool Football Club, before we consider a massive bill for someone who's at the top of his game and maybe just on the crest of that and coming down. That's fine to sell someone then when you've got somebody into a place. We should be getting Phil Coutinho's replacement in now, or he should already be at the club. I don't think we've got that, and that's one of the reasons I don't think we'll sell.
Right, thanks for watching. That was our talk about Phil Coutinho and why Mark Lawrenson's an idiot. that's what it was. That was part of our Top of the League Reds News Roundup show. If you think you'd like to watch the full show, it was about 45, 50 minutes talking, speaking about Coutinho, Sturridge, Mignolet, Danny Ward, Iago Aspas even got a mention, so did Victor Moses. A bit of Paul Konchesky chat as well, if that's your thing. Hopefully it is. That's worth your £2, isn't it? I say, if you want to watch the whole show, if you click these buttons that the lads are hopefully put on in magic here, go and sign up to the website. It's £2 a month. Your first month is free, so you can log in, check the shows out if you fancy watching them, you know, carry on paying. If you don't, fair enough, it's not for you. I think it's worth the money. I'm a subscriber. That's pretty much it. So thanks for watching. Tune in next time. Ta-da.